guys. Well, we're going to get started. I'm really excited to be here. You guys, the digital marketing world, it's kind of changing. Would you agree?
Yes.
What's happening to it in your world?
Fast.
Yeah? When you guys are out and about, what do you guys see people living on?
Smartphones.
These. Yes? I usually could pinpoint how many people are not wearing underwear versus how many people don't have their cell phones with them. This is literally the only thing that everybody does not leave without. How many of you, if you left and you were halfway here, would turn around if you didn't take a flight to go home and get your cell phone? How many of you sleep with it within a foot away from your bed? Okay, you have problems. there's medication for that. Okay. No, see, I cheat. My phone's always plugged up in a different room. I just have my Apple Watch on. So, it doesn't count. It doesn't count. All right, so the challenge is, you guys, I'm gonna make sure that this is educational for everyone who's already heard me speak, but I also wanna make sure that everybody gets brought up to speed as well. So we're gonna bounce around a little bit. I'd prefer to stay out of the PowerPoint as much as possible and just get into the meat of marketing, meat of websites, technology, databases, infrastructure as far as technology goes. And I really would like this to be interactive. So this is a good opportunity to volunteer your website. Speaking of which, if you have a website you'd like me to evaluate while we're up here and give you some pointers, things that are going well, things we could do better and so forth, take your business card out. Who's bold enough to volunteer? Raise your hand. All right, awesome. Take your business card out. Mike's gonna come grab those. And we're gonna plug those in. So how many of you built your website yourself? Okay, so I have two that could potentially be offended. Put those cards in one hand. Everyone else, you guys can blame it on everyone else. The reality is that the way technology is changing, I mean, devices, Google, search, how people are communicating, whether it's now on a watch or a phone or a PC or a Mac or an Android or an iPhone, the devices, the operating systems, the technology is changing so rapidly. It's very, very difficult. In fact, a website's life cycle today, who do I need to be cautious of feelings? This one? Okay. I'm just kidding. They all did. Okay, we'll be nice. I'm just kidding. The reality, a life cycle of a website today is about 18 to 24 months. How many of you have a website that's older than 24 months? Okay. And that's normal. But it comes with challenges, a lot of challenges. So I'm gonna actually get out of here. For those of you that don't know us, here. Really quick, we're a team of about 65. We have people all over the world. We have, let's see here, we're in Seattle, we're in Texas, Houston, Dallas, New York, Florida, California. Did I say Seattle? Okay. We're also, we have teams in India, in Nepal and Ramamandri, and we also have teams in Pune, India, which is by the Air Force there. So we run basically a 6-day clock, 20 hours a day. We've got three different shifts, and it's morning, noon, and night meetings, I'll say that. So sleep is good. All right, now, let's go check. I'm gonna actually pull up a couple of these sites, and a couple questions while I pull these up. Actually, Mike, will you do this for me? Will you find these? I already have Bort Bremerton up. How many of you guys feel like you have control or you're at least an influencer of your website and the things that you have digitally? At least an influencer? You want me to pull it up? Closer? Further? Oh. Which one?
Barbara asked if that's the wrong address.
What's your website address? Do you know it?
The one I wrote on the back.
Oh.
Yeah.
Got it. Okay. How many of you feel like you absolutely have zero control and are not an influence? Yeah? Kind of? Tell me your situation, Port, City?
It's the city of Sitka. It's just run by our IT department right now. That's what the city wants to do. That's not what we want to do. And we're kind of in a...
Okay. Yes, and that requires some influence. Anyone else in that situation? IT's running it? Okay. So I can probably tell you what's going on with your sites there, because some, usually the IT guys, it's different. They're network administrators, they're database managers, they're security, email, help desk, support, software, hardware, definitely not web marketing. So the challenge is building a website or having an effective digital presence, I should say, requires a massive team. Has anybody just hired the guy, Bob, one guy? Yeah, how'd that go?
Great so
far. Awesome. Based on whose measurements?
I don't know, you'll have to check it out.
Do I have your card? All right, awesome. Okay, so challenges, you guys, these guys don't come in one body. Has anybody ever known a developer, a coder? Yeah, what are they like?
Strange, caffeinated.
Strange, highly caffeinated. Yes, alcohol or caffeine, one of the two. Techno music, possibly. Red Bull?
Almost definitely.
Almost always. Okay. The garage is actually a living space called an office. You know? On a Friday night, would you see them going out with a whole bunch of friends? Probably not. They're with friends, but their friends' names are like Toxic M64, and he's on an IRC relay channel online. He feels like he's hanging out with 90 people he's actually never met. Okay. What about a graphics designer? Anyone known a graphics designer?
Yeah.
Yes. What are they like?
Same.
Yeah? Okay. What else?
Artsy, weird.
Artsies? Okay, weird. Do they dress nice? Are they creative?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Would they have friends get dressed up and go out with their friends on a Friday night? Absolutely. Their living room is actually the main area, not the garage. Anybody known an engineer? Okay. Anyone an engineer in the room? Okay. All I have to do is pick out the ties. Are you holding a BlackBerry? No, I'm just kidding. I'm totally joking. Okay. Are you head of finance?
No.
Okay. Okay, so what are engineers like? Close your ears. What are they like?
Dry.
Dry, potentially, yes.
Organized.
Very, absolutely. Absolutely. Do they make decisions quickly?
No.
No, why? Because they're doing what?
Calculations,
researching, analyzing, still. Okay? Those are SEO engineers, search engine optimization engineers. Those are the ones that have to get your website to be on page one of Google out of how many ever competitors there are for any particular search. All they do? Math. Anyone known as a social media marketer? Yes, what are they like?
I've met a lot and they're pretty different, average people, I'd say.
Yeah, sometimes a little flighty. You wonder if the dollars you're spending on them are actually ever gonna make you any money. What are they doing? Do I really care about what they're eating for breakfast? Do other people care what we're eating for breakfast? Right? Okay, social media marketers, they're friends with everybody, highly social butterflies, definitely not recruits, totally opposite of a developer. Do you agree?
Yeah.
Okay. So I could keep going, because you have to have content writers, you have to have content editors, there's a whole bunch of roles that have to be engaged, but the biggest thing is these guys, who do you think they think opinion is most important?
Their own.
Do they run companies? So that's the challenge, is you guys are in a little bit of a quandary, okay? If you have the IT department in there, you have a bunch of technical people, that's a certain personality style. These personality styles, they're not born in the same body. If you found one that had all four different personality styles, because it did pinpoint four very different personality styles, let me know, because we'd pay them a lot of money, okay? We're recruiting. All right, so the challenge is that you also have to have a business strategist, especially you. You guys have an entirely different business than every other company out there. Heavily operationally funded. I'm gonna say, you guys have the most amount of data and paperwork and record keeping and laws and regulations and things that you have to track for the safety and for the operations and logistics of running your business. So throw out a handful of them. Operationally, how does the technology play a role in your business right now? What do people do with it?
Access information.
They access information. Like what?
Rates.
Perfect. What else?
Services.
What else?
Payment schedules.
Payment schedules, absolutely. What else? How many of you take payments online? Okay, how many of you have your rates online? How many of you allow people to sign up for emergency notifications online? Okay, how many of you send emergency notifications via text, email? Email, okay. All right, so you guys have a lot of data. The hard part is in any business, if you don't leverage technology, the only other option is what? It's humans, it's people. So on one hand, we sit in a position where we don't want to invest in technology because we're looking at a line item for a budget, right? But on the other hand, what we're not realizing is that as a business owner, we're doing things continually that are repetitive, duplicate processes, redundant. Are those three words similar? Which all cost human capital, and that costs you money every single day. There's other things we could be spending our time on. Okay, so that being said, from a digital marketing standpoint, there's only three ways to make money on the internet. There's only three. If somebody is searching, so tell me what you would love for one of your prospects to search for. Is it boat repair in blank?
Moorage.
Boat maintenance? Moorage, where?
Moorage Falls Creek.
What kind of boat? What slip do you have available?
I don't know.
Okay, so when you're sitting here staring at this filing cabinet, because that's really what this is. Google's a huge filing cabinet. Any of you seen Bruce Almighty?
Yeah.
You remember when there's that big warehouse, God goes in there, yep, and he says, anything you've ever thought, anything you've ever done, anything you've ever said is in this drawer. Whew, and this thing flies across the entire warehouse? That's Google. One search produces one drawer of information. Pages, not websites, pages. So, one way somebody could look is they could look for moorage. Now, if somebody looks for moorage, there are 428,000, actually, and I'm on someone else's computer and you're on your personal results. That's gonna be interesting. Okay, so let's go. Let's go boat moorage. Actually, let's do boat slips. So this number right here, there's 1.8. Now, the results are gonna be different because I'm in Canada, okay? There is, so this is actually gonna show the personal results of this computer based on their search history, unless I was logged into his account and I turned off his personal results. Okay, so it doesn't mean just because you search yourself or you search for something that if you pop up on page one, you're actually on page one. Because Google is tracking everything based on your search history. Okay? So, All right, so if I said boat slip for rent, for example, PC. Have you ever used somebody else's computer? Does it feel odd? Yeah. Okay, so same thing. God, these look so interesting. They're so low here. In the US, if we were physically located in the US right now, that number's in the millions. So it's really different, really, really different. Every single search is gonna give you a number of competitors, basically competitive pages. It's up here on the top left-hand corner. This one is how many? 454,000. So in order for you to make money on this search, you have three places you can show up. One would be pay-per-click. So if I said in Vancouver, COU, what happens to the number?
Smaller.
Much smaller.
You have a marina name in there.
Oh. I can tell how he searches. Okay, so let's go boat slip in Vancouver. Now how many?
240.
All right, so there's three ways to make money here. One is a Google business listing. How many of you have a Google business listing set up for sure? Google Maps. Okay, this is free. So you need to go to Google My Business, write down that URL if you don't have it, go to Google My Business. You need to set up a Google business listing account. That's gonna put you on the map. All right, now why that's important? One, because if I search and I search by location, that's what I get. The other one is if somebody has a phone, depending on if it's an Android or if it's a PC or a Siri, Apple. Siri. Let me see if she likes me, because it's all on airplane mode and everything. How many of you have done a search on your phone just talking to it? Yeah? Okay. Siri. What is it? Boat slip available in Vancouver, BC. She's searching for Wi-Fi. Okay, we'll see. So the difference is this search, what it's gonna pull up, it's only gonna pull up Google Maps. It's not gonna pull up Google search. So even if your website's on page one of Google, because you do an organic search, if you pull it up on a phone and somebody's talking to their phone or they're talking to their watch, the only results that are gonna come back is gonna be Google Maps listing, Google Business listing, which is part of Google Places, which is part of Google Plus, which is attached to a Gmail account. Does that make sense?
Yep.
All right, awesome. Okay, so there's only three spots of...
with the connection. Please try again in a moment.
No, you're late.
Yeah.
Okay.
So can it place if it needs it?
Here. Michael, you want this? You want to come set her up? Okay, so in here you only have three listings. Any thoughts on what listings get to showcase here?
What's the contents in their pages?
Okay. What else?
Keyword searches.
Okay, this is a little different. So Google, yes. So the number one indicator, there's many different factors. The number one indicator of how your business, out of three, gets to be showcased on that listing is the number of reviews you have. So on a website, having right at the very top of your website something that says like us, review us on Google. In your social media, send out a social media campaign. You can automate it and we can have it post literally every 10 days for the next 15 years. That it says leave us a review on Google, get $25 off your next blank, whatever that is. Is it worth it to get reviews? Absolutely. Because any type of Google searches that are coming from a phone, you're looking at places first. So reviews here are more important than anything else. More important than Yelp, more important than any of the other major business listings. Make sense? And this is free. Free, free, free. So this one's a good no-brainer. All right, the other is pay-per-click. In this search, you guys actually have a lot less, especially here, I've noticed the searches, a lot less people investing in pay-per-click. In the Seattle area, there's a lot of people that are investing in pay-per-click. Those are the ads that show up at the very top, typically 3 to 4 ads, or the ads that show up on the right-hand margin. How many of you are familiar with pay-per-click? Yes? A little bit? Okay. So essentially, pay-per-click, just giving you a quick outline, is when an agency would set up multiple campaigns depending on the type of search. So a campaign may be for haulouts, a campaign may be for boat maintenance, a campaign may be for mortgage, or office space available, or real estate available, depending on what you have at your specific marina or port. Each campaign can be tagged to hundreds or thousands of different keyword variations. You would pay an agency to manage the campaign, and they would design one landing page per campaign. So if somebody was looking for haulouts, you'd want them to go just to the haulout page. If they were looking for dry dock, you'd have them go just to the dry dock page. If they were looking for boat storage, you'd take them to that page. Make sense? Now, you take your credit card, you leave it on file with Google, never with an agency. And anytime somebody clicks on that link, goes to your landing page for that particular campaign, Google will remove $4, $5, $7, $12, whatever it is from your credit card for that particular key phrase, depending on the value of it. Make sense? Okay, so that's the second way. Third is organic, right here. Now, you guys are in a really interesting position, and I'm curious what's gonna happen over the next few years. The industry as a whole is pretty behind. Would you agree, from a technology standpoint? Okay, so, and the problem is there's a whole bunch of companies that build technologies for you guys that are also behind but still selling, which is worse, okay? And it's hard to tell the difference, it's not what you do all day, right? So, right now, you guys don't have the same level of competition you will have when your competitors or surrounding marinas and ports start doing it right, okay? So normally, in this environment here, these would be considered organic results. And in order to get ranked here, you'll notice that whatever I'm searching for, so it's this industry, so funny. So see how Google is highlighting? It's making the words dark that I looked for in my search. So there's Vancouver, there's Marina, there's Marina. You see what I mean? It's pulling from those. There's three things that it's looking at first. One is the name of the page. The second thing is the link and or permalink. And a permalink is everything after the .com. So if you had a page on your website that was www.mymarina.com/mortgage rates in Vancouver. Another one, www.mywebsite.com/best boat mortgage in blank. 42-foot slip available in Seattle, in Anacortes, and so forth. If you had one page per type of search, you guys can actually own and occupy as unlimited searches because you're adding just pages. Challenges is when we go to your websites, most of you guys have a place that says availability, and it just has one page, and all we do is put a handful of them on one page, and most of the time they're also just called availability. So if I look for availability on Google, because that's a technically, so every time we label a page on our site, I'm not gonna search for that. I'm afraid, I don't wanna search for that. Okay. I've been caught off guard before. How about we look for services? Go safe. Okay, so how many of you have a page on your website called services or our services? Yeah? How many competitive pages are on there?
5 billion.
5 billion. So that's what I mean. The more generic every page is, the more difficult this search is. So you're going into a bucket with everything under the sun, every website in every industry that also has a page called our services on it. The more literal your pages are on your website, the more literal a search, the more consumers who are looking for that exact thing you're gonna be in front of. And you're gonna be in front of where they're already searching day in and day out. Does that make sense? Okay.
Does that count just for after the .com or if it's before?
So what's your if it's before the .com, which is your actual URL, if you have a URL called marinas, or marina, mortgageinvancouver.com. For example, right now you definitely have preferential treatment, but Google also put a requirement in called an exact match domain penalty. Over time, as Google evaluates websites for compliance, if your website is not compliant with the many, many, many requirements of Google, I'll go the biggest one right now is your website mobile responsive? Then you can actually be penalized and your website can go down even though it's an exact match domain search, exactly what a consumer's looking for. Make sense? Okay. All right, so let's go glance at a handful of sites. Where is my Port of Bremerton? All right, awesome. Okay, so I'm just gonna go through a handful of things. The first thing you wanna check on every website is that you notice if I drag this over, you notice how you lose half of the website? That's the first indication that the website is not mobile responsive. It's not gonna pass that test, okay? Mobile responsive means that your website will reshape itself. So I'll go pull up. Let's actually add this one.
That's how you test it on a desktop, drag.
Yep, that's the easiest way to test it. I would normally look differently, but okay. So we'll go grab one of our sites and I'll just show you the difference so you can kind of get an idea. So this is one we just went live with. So if you grab the site, PC, and you drag it over, I can do that one too. So drag it over, you should see the website reshape itself. So it maintains aspect ratio, so it doesn't look really tiny on a phone. Have you ever went to a website on a phone and you're like this, trying to stretch the page, and then you actually get to a little tiny phone number and you try and tap it to call them, nothing happens. I wanna do one of these with my phone out the sunroof. Okay, you actually wanna call. So what do you guys do when that happens? If you're searching, just random, you're just dad.
Don't look at it.
Are you turning your phone
turn your phone sideways, then try and stretch, and if you tap the phone number, then what do?
Stop.
You stop.
Go to the next site.
You go to the next site, absolutely. And this is the thing. In every industry, as consumers, we have to be really careful because a lot of times we're subject matter experts in our own industry, and we actually stop thinking like mom, dad, aunt, uncle, homeowner, boat owner, and we start thinking just like business owner. In reality, so let's go back and let's just be, how many of you are moms and dads? All right, awesome. We'll start there. Homeowners, everyone else. Awesome. If your roof falls apart because of hail, what are you going to do?
Call your insurance.
Call your insurance. Yes. And they're going to say, sure, go find us something, and you're going to do what?
Call a roof repair.
How are you going to call a roof repair?
The delegate.
And how are you going to get their number?
The delegates.
You're going to go to the Yellow Pages. You own a Yellow Pages. Do you have a toddler?
For me?
I'm just kidding.
I do have a toddler.
You do? Okay. No, I've only seen Yellow Pages used as booster seats lately, and doorstops, and sometimes fire starters. But yes.
I'm going to ask Siri for roofers in my location.
You're going to ask Siri. Okay. Anyone else? What are you going to do?
Google it.
You're going to Google it. What are you going to do? Bremerton.
Google.
Google. Angie's List.
Angie's List. All right. What are you going to do? Go. What are you going to do? Google.
Ask Jeeves.
Ask Jeeves. Does that still exist? Where are you from? No, I'm just kidding. How many of you are going to go to Google and you're going to search for roof repair in whatever my city is? Okay, hold your hand high and look around. Okay, everyone look around. Perfect. How many of you are going to call a friend and ask for a referral? Raise your hand and look around. Okay, raise your hand and look around. How many of you, once you get the referral, are going to go to Google and you're going to research ABC Roofing Company before you actually make the call, even if it was referred by your mother? Turn around, look around. If the reviews are negative or there are no reviews or you can't figure out what company they are because they're not listed, are you going to make the call? Okay? It's that simple. I promise you it's that simple. That's how consumers search. When we go back into what do I do as a homeowner, as mom, as dad, if I need to find a contractor or I need to find a place to moor my boat or I need to find a place to do repairs on my car, we do two things. One, we go to Google and search. Sometimes we talk to our phone or our watch, or we type it in on a computer or a tablet. Two, we ask a friend. And then, once we get a referral, we always go look them up. And it's that way. It wasn't that way 3 years ago. It might not even, I think I want to say it was probably, I still had at least 10% of the room that was saying they would call the referral regardless, they wouldn't go do a search. I don't have that anymore, not this year, in every speaking event. Okay, so, same thing here. When you go to the site, it's going to reshape itself, and it's going to put all your most important things up top. Make sense? That's responsive. 5 years ago, we used to build two websites. They were mobile sites. So you had your regular website, and then you had a mobile version of your site. Totally not legal anymore. Then we went to HTML5. Then Google said your website has to be responsive. The nerd version is you have to have 3,000 different style sheets in order to make sure your website fits and reshapes itself on hundreds of different devices. Okay? Now, little things on websites that have a huge impact, and you would never know if it had an impact, is the phone number click to call. Meaning if somebody taps that phone number from a phone or from a tablet, is it going to auto call you? Okay, really, really, really important. You guys also, people, they're out on the water making things easy, such as putting their VHF number on there, being able to schedule service, schedule haulouts. Right now, I think these guys, summer reservations is huge right now. Anyone else have summer reservations open? Anyone else have such a craze that you have to turn it on and turn it off? No? Would you like to? Okay, awesome. So for Port of Owako, we have summer reservations. Notice, when you want somebody to do something, what I notice on a lot of sites is it's like intermixed in the text. It's just part of a paragraph. If you want somebody to do something, make it big, make it bright, make it stand out. That's called a CTA, or a call to action. So, summer reservations, reserve now. And of course, we are turning it on and turning it off because we're almost sold out. Bless you. And that's in 3 weeks. Not bad. Okay, same thing. Boater resources. What I notice on a lot of sites is they're templates and they have a lot of text on them. Text is great for Google if it's done right, if it's partitioned into the right pages and searches. Text, too much text is not great for people. Do you guys love picking up a website and just reading? Are you guys quick to go, what's the fastest way to the gold? I'm looking for the pretty picture and I'm gonna click. Right? We have to be careful because you guys have two audiences. Google is an audience, but all it is a robot. That's your engineer. All it does is mathematical evaluation of your website, and it makes decisions based on math. People are different, though. People have a first impression. So when they're coming to the site, what is the first impression as soon as they get there? There's obvious personal preference. So let's see here. I started on Bremerton. Let me just not let my ADD get the best of me. All right, so out of the things I just covered, what is missing right out of the gate on the very top?
Call to action,
absolutely. What do you want them to do? So it's real generic, and it's, you know, text, but we want to drive them into something. So what do you want? Is it the middle of spring and fall and you guys are slow? Is it the middle of winter and it's slow for new reservations? Do you guys have a specific slip to fill? Having an area, yes?
So this is our website. Our thing is we have airport, industrial park, marinas. For us, would it make more sense to split them out? I mean, we have it in a little bit about business development, marinas, rep. I mean, how do you cover all, because they're all different phone numbers?
Yeah, you don't have to do that. So I was trying to think of an example.
I don't. There, which if they call that number, they're going to get the airport, they're trying to get the marina, and they're going to be dissatisfied as well.
So easiest thing to do for that, well, a couple things would make it easy. Trying to think. One of the things you can do is you can use an embedded system in here where you can set up, so for example, instead of these having our names, you could have one link that says airport, one link that says marina, one that says reservations, and so forth. So you can separate it here. This system will allow them to come to the site. They can choose what they want. So instead of it being people, it would actually be the areas, the departments. So for example, if they chose airport, and they can set time to speak with somebody at a different time. So that's one way to do that. And the system will manage and coordinate those appointments. So instead of just having the phones ring off the hook, that's an option. You can also put at the very top of your website, you can put a note that says contact information below or phone numbers below, or you can actually have, we've got, what's an HVAC site that has more than one number right at the top? I can't remember, if you think of it. So that's another way you can do it. So there's always going to be a way, but you can actually have each one of the numbers. What is it? Cool in Tampa? Good job. Okay. If you got that from memory, you are the man. Well, you are anyway. But okay, so. All right, so that's a great example. So for them, they've got a bright phone number at the top, that's for emergencies only. Then to the right-hand side, instead of it being by location, you can actually have each individual group, okay? So you'll see on here, they have that, but they also have the scheduling system that's integrated in there. So if somebody comes to your site, they need to talk to you about something, they don't have time right now, let them set a note. There's no reason your phones have to blow off the hook. Let people schedule an appointment for their lunch break on Wednesday if your calendar's open. So there's little things you can do to ease up operations and let the system do the reminders and notifications. Just like that. Right click, left click, don't double tap. So same thing.
So back to that Bremerton, if the call to action was the mortgage deal, they've got a big mortgage deal, but there.
But you don't get to it until you go to Bremerton.
Well, you also, so the way that the site is structured, you're only using about 2/3 of the physical room on a website because it's an old site, I'm guessing, or someone old built it. I don't know. Okay. So it now websites are full width because they're dynamic. So because they shrink and expand, they're dynamic. So you have more space. You also are not taking advantage of something like this where you have a slider that can rotate and it can go through and it can highlight two or three different things on a slider. As these things move through, theirs is going to be static for a while, and so forth. You'll see these guys, I don't know if they have one or more. So see how they have multiple sliders that go through? Depending on what it is. So having something clear that you can change out seasonally, change out based on the business, that would help as well. All right, so phone number, VHF number, making sure the website's responsive. Little things like phone numbers not being clicked to call in the footer, making sure your address is, if somebody's on a phone and they see your address, they want to tap it so that it'll automatically do a pull-up map quest. Those are really little things you can do as well. Now, let's go see.
Can you go to the marinas?
Yep.
And now we've got two marinas off to the left.
Okay, so you have Bremerton.
That's the specialty. See how you have to click all the way in there to get to it?
Yeah, absolutely. So it's really just organization, and then your navigation changes slightly. So you could do this same thing. Look at this site. See how they have a top level navigation up here? And then they have a secondary navigation down here. You can do that exact same thing. So your main navigation could be so they could go from the port to the marina to the airport and so forth. And a secondary navigation could be for each individual group. And that would make it easier for people to navigate. So everything's one click away instead of two and three clicks in. All right. So other things that are a challenge, events. You know, I notice a lot of these, the event systems that are on sites are just text. Challenge with this is they can't add it to their calendar, they can't search, they can't sort, it's not individually indexed by Google. So being able to have a calendar that they can actually look at, that's gonna help as well. Just little things. Small little things like having social media accounts that are kind of randomly on interior pages, put them in the footer or put them in the header and call it a day. You don't need to have them on interior pages. They don't need to be spread out through the site. People are used to seeing them right smack at the top of the site or at the very bottom of the footer. And you guys, the footer of the website, so when I'm talking about this is the header area, really important. This is main navigation. That's a slider. These are bodies. So you notice what's important to these guys right out of the gate?
Clear.
Is it clean? Very clean, very clear. You can do that by individual area within each division of yours as well. So those are the things that are most important. They also want to be able to highlight. So if you're going to do something that's what new, keep it out, keep it separate, more white space, I should say. This has a little bit more design to it. And really highlight, these are the new things. They're doing a lot of construction, they're adding on new things and so forth. Pictures, videos, everybody loves them. Upcoming events, getting it onto a calendar. Also, things that are recurring. So there's something called tailgate marketing. It's my little name for it. But essentially, if no one knows about you, but they do know there's a kite festival that happens every year in the city that's closest to you, for example, and they go to Google and they're searching for the kite festival in Long Beach. If they're looking for that, if you have on your website pages or posts or events regarding the kite festival, as they search, hopefully they're gonna get Long Beach website with the information on the kite festival, and directly underneath that, they get yours. So you wanna line up next to those things. It basically means you're using somebody else's brand or someone else's event in order to drive them to your website. Does that make sense? Okay, so recent blog posts. Always making sure that you guys have a tenant and guest area. There's so many things, whether it's tide and weather and vessel, haulouts, maintenance service, streaming video, if you have security cameras at your location, emergency notifications, forms and documents, resources, if you've got compliance documents, and so forth, your board meetings, your meeting notes, and all of those things. So it's really clean and clear, and they have an area that they can go to. Those are recent blog posts. So these guys, we've gotten really good at getting them to become more documentary about their events, things that they have. So when they had the sailboat races, they did it there. When they had a big party, they did it there, and so forth. So those are their blog posts. How many of you are familiar with WordPress? Okay. So if you're not, the benefit of WordPress, there's thousands of them. However, you basically have a website and a blog in the same content management system. So you guys need a blog, hands down, because you have too much stuff that has to go on a website to just have page after page after page after page. You guys, anything that is recurring. So tell me the kind of content you have to put on your website that's recurring.
Newsletter.
Newsletter, perfect. What else? Go.
Festivals.
Festivals, go. Events, perfect. What else? Meeting notes. Availability, openings. Absolutely. What else?
Physical.
Absolutely. If you guys are doing renovations, if there's new things coming on, if there's a notice of a closure for a particular area, if a dock's getting a new camera system or a new gate, if there's a new guest policy, absolutely. So the way that a blog works from an organization standpoint is every one of these can fit inside a category. So this particular post, go search, start, fits inside a category. So you guys need a lot of categories. So these are searches, those are archives. So notice on here, we have categories for expansion projects. We have a category for their VRBO, for haulouts, for boatyard, for the paddler's cup. Everything that's redundant, recurring, where you want to be able to communicate on a regular basis. The great part about this is, for example, this particular category or this particular category, you can have unlimited posts inside this category. So they get new restrooms. Then we have, they're popular at the Seattle Boat Show, engine work complete on Gig Harbor Marina and Boatyard and so forth. Every time they're doing that, they're putting another what inside Google's file drawer?
Page.
They're putting another page in there. The more pages you own in that really large drawer, the more people you're in front of, depending on what you title it. So if I titled this, great job team, what kind of bucket is it gonna go in?
A great big one.
Yes. Junk drawer. Just think of your kitchen. You have a junk drawer in there? That's what most pages go under, okay? We don't want it in the junk drawer. We want it in the organized knives, spoons, okay? All right. So let's roll back here. Salt Springs. So there's really that site, it just needs an overhaul because there's not a design, there's not a structure behind it. It just needs, you know, a good strategy as far as what's important, what do you need to address first by each individual department, and then the design framework needs to come together, and then the data goes into the buckets. It's really actually not that difficult. Okay, this one, same thing. Anytime you see a frame around a site, yeah, I can pretty much tell if it's going to be old or not responsive because it's got the frame around it. Where's my Salt Springs? Awesome. Okay. Did I say? Oh, okay. My bad. All right, so what are we on? How do you double click on here? Oh, yeah. Start, go, two. Okay. So you're in a WordPress. That is good. So little things is they took the blog area, they named it news. Having a phone number right out of the gate. If you're going to have certifications and so forth, usually you want to create an area that says our certifications, put it in the footer and so forth. Call to actions right out of the gate. What is the site telling you to do as soon as you get here? So and that's the challenge. We got to engage people. We got to bring them right into. People are going to come to your site two ways. If they go to Google and they do a search, hopefully they land on an interior page. If they get a referral and they come to your site, then they're coming to your homepage. So there's two different entry points in there. So same things right out of the gate. We've got news that can be a container or a section, but we really want to focus on the things that are most important out of the gate versus just news. Okay, and there can be an area where people can subscribe to news. And then same thing, if we go in, the way we have everything labeled, we have this labeled as events. If you put a location in there, if it was things to do in blank, everybody looks for things to do in blank. Everyone that's traveling does that. That's a great way to put events in instead of just events. And having titles for these. So because they're all on you know, one big long thing, the only bucket we're going into is a big bucket called events instead of using an event system where each one has its own. Okay? Rates. Same thing. So we have a page, it's called rates. There's rates for everything under the sun. There's mortgage rates and house rates and, you know, financial loan rates and everything else. So you want to be really, really clear. So it's mortgage and slip rental rates in blank as far as your titles. So every page on here, members, news, audits, links, photos, rates, events, news, pretty much every page in here needs to be more direct. It needs to tell them specifically what they're looking for and where they're looking for it.
So question, like,
Yes.
You wouldn't put all of that in that little box. That was just in rates, but up in the URL, it would be rates and if you're slipping.
Exactly. So the permalink changes, which is everything after the .com, and then your title here needs to match whatever that primary phrase is, but this can just be a different menu label. So that's easy to do. And then the other thing that's kind of weird is there's the news feed and then there's an RSS feed. Technically, those are the same thing. So we basically have the whole front of the website with a blog on the front of it instead of things that are going to gear towards new business, new traffic, and so forth, new conversions. Okay. So this is probably responsive, I'm guessing. Yes. So this is also probably a template. So little things on this one, whoever set it up, where's...
Just the one with the one guy.
Okay, so Bob. So I was just going to say whoever set it up probably is not a server administrator because they didn't install it on the server, right? So when you install a site on a server, it needs to be auto-rerouted to www.mywebsite.com. Right now, Google thinks with the W's, without the W's, is two different sites. If we have a big SEO conversation, that's really, really important. But I don't want to get that nerdy today. Okay, same thing, the story. How preserve, that's good. Today's with preserved. So let's just roll in here. Okay, so no, no, and no. You hired a developer, not a designer. So the developer, the reason I can tell, one, it's an ASP.NET framework. So ASP, a marketing person would call it bloatware. They sink to the bottom. Whereas PHP is lightweight, free to roam. Challenge with this is, see how all of the pages, there's no dashes in between any of the words. So Google thinks that is one single word called, how to preserve words isn't made. I don't know how to do that. Okay. So everything has to be indexed individually as individual words. If he was using a content management system like WordPress, he couldn't have messed it. He'd have to work hard to mess it up, I'd say that. Google won't index that. Also, he's got things under subcategories. Google doesn't care about the story. Psh, take it out, doesn't matter. All you want is the actual key phrase that's going to be at the very top. Okay? Same thing, and my guess is the whole site's going to be the same way. So every page on the site, this whole area is called how to. This should technically be in a post category, so this should be under a category called blog, and then secondary categories, how to what. And so it would need to say how to do blank, how to create a fastener, how to do field treatment, way out of my zone of knowledge, okay? I can tell you how to label it, you just tell me what it is. All right, tech resources, same thing, even getting down into FAQs. So he took every single FAQ and put it on one page so Google can't index anything except what?
Tech FAQ.
And you go into the most famous bucket in the world outside of our services, yeah, which is 1.5 billion. Other pages.
Jennifer, we are running a little bit late, so we'll give you a little bit more time, but I just want to let you know.
Oh, awesome. Thank you. Okay. Anyone else you want me to go over it really fast? Is this helpful?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. All right, so in a nutshell, you guys, the first thing is making sure you are in the right technology. The way to do that is, one, you have to have a strategist that understands all of those nerds I talked about earlier, designers, developers, engineers, SEO guys, social media guys, and so forth. But you guys are in an interesting situation. You also have to have somebody that understands marinas and ports, all of your regulations, all of your restrictions. Are you reporting to a board? Do you have a committee? Do you have an IT department that you have to go go after? Is there somebody you need to, in order to get the job done, whatever you're... Also, you guys have a lot of finite details as far as the information you're required to track and maintain. So if you need to know every single person that's currently moored at your location, when does their leases expire, what are their current monthly rates, what amenities do they have, do you have their vehicle license plate, do you have their trailer license plate, do they have an extra slot for storage, whatever those things are, all of that needs to get into a database so it's really, really easy to track and you guys get out of paper as quickly as possible. Okay, so you guys are in a little bit of a challenging situation because it's going to be hard to find a web agency that understands the technicalities of marinas and ports at the exact same time, and you really need both. But when you're in a good position, you'll feel it because they'll be asking you more questions than you telling them more answers. Instead of you feeling like you're trying to run with a technology person and tell them what you need and you'd actually, this isn't what you do. Does that make sense? Okay, so before we wrap up, anyone have any questions that's just daunting? I need to get this, I'm not sure how this works.
I guess I have a question. Will you be available later this evening? We have an exhibitor's reception in case people want to come and reach you or talk to you one-on-one.
Kind of not. You remember in the beginning when I said something about spring break?
Yes.
Okay, so we have to drive home to Seattle, pack our kids, and get on an airplane to go on a cruise for 4 days because that's all we gave them. So, what we will do though, that's one of them. That's my dad. So I'm bringing this up though, because all this stuff, it feels frustrating, especially if it's not your gig. And it's scary, and the technology is scary, and going through the change, and feeling like this is gonna be this massive, exorbitant, you know, huge project, and you're too busy to take it on. I promise you, if you're with the right agency, it's not that difficult. We know more about what you need than you do and so forth. It's not gonna take out a bunch of time, and what you don't wanna do is be spinning your wheels doing the same redundant things over and over and over, year over year, only to be sitting in the same position because you don't wanna take the time. So there's two ways to take this roller coaster ride. They were both on the same roller coaster. One chose to go through it one way, and the other one chose a different way. All it is a choice, okay? As far as how to get moving, so what I'm gonna recommend, how many of you are interested in sitting down at least having a strategy session with us? Okay, awesome. For you guys, take your card, give it to Mike. He will trade you a business card. He'll give you one of ours. To reserve time fast so that you get that spot, if you go to CI Web Group, which will be on that card, click on contact, click on schedule now, pick me. Okay? So pick that one right there and choose a time. Book it today or book it tomorrow. Grab your phone. You can do it from your phone real quick. And get time set up on my calendar because it gets packed really, really, really easy. We'll jump on a webinar. We don't have to be face-to-face. If you're in our neck of the woods, we will be face-to-face because we love getting out. We live in Edmonds, and so it's an easy drive for us to get to and from and so forth. But get those on the books. We'll go through. We'll do a complete evaluation of your website in more detail, figure out what you need. And the more upfront you are with us about what some of your difficulties are as far as getting this approved or passing through the right people or right resources, I promise you we've done all of it 100 times. We can help you put together the right information and the right bullet points to be able to get that through. Cool?
Awesome.
Fantastic. Thanks you guys for having me back.